Hold up. You want me to do my makeup using no makeup tools and only using things I find in my house? I'm gonna try. So I am on vacation, but I found some things, okay? The vibes are very barbecue, but we're gonna give it a chance. Okay, let's do concealer first, and I'm gonna use a spoon. I chose a spoon. I don't know how we ended up here, but we are here. Not gonna lie, it feels nice, but it shouldn't. Spoons are low-key good for blending. What is this? I brought up the fork. It feels slightly illegal. I found this salt thing. There is now salt in my contour. I feel like the fork needs more action. We need eyebrows. Why is this actually working? I'm gonna blend everything with this, so if you want to see that, go to part two. Welcome to part two of me doing my makeup with random things I find in my house. We're gonna blend this now. I guess I'm gonna get this wet. I cut it so it will be more practical. It's low-key not even that bad. I mean, don't do this, please. I feel like a freshly washed dish. My skin may be ruined, but it's okay for blending. My whole face is in pain, but like, it worked. It did. This every day, but we have the brush. And now the eyeshadow. Yep, toilet paper. Okay, let's go red. I'm gonna dab it a little bit. Then I'm doing orange. And then I'm also gonna do a yellow. I'm gonna go put on lashes. Be the makeup done. Honestly, I killed this.
Hi guys, today I'm gonna be setting my makeup using powdered sugar. I genuinely have no idea how this is gonna go. It looks like cottage cheese. All right, let me dip my sponge in here. Here we go. Well, it's definitely similar consistency to powder. I inhaled a little bit of it and it tasted good, so that's a plus. Let's snatch the nose because we don't need to breathe. I'm just gonna take this beauty blender and just get the rest of my under eyes. We might as well just set my forehead. Now let's dust this off for the reveal. It looks so good. Highly recommend. She sprayed her bronzer and made it into cream contour. That is so smart. I have the exact same bronzer, so let's do it. It physically pains me to do this. This feels very wrong. She's looking nice and moist, so let's dip it. Here's what we're looking like. Brush. It feels really creamy when it's going on. Now I'm gonna blend it out with a different brush. I feel like it's blending easier than actual cream contour. Now I'm gonna do actual cream contour on the other half of my face to compare. I don't feel like the bronzer half of my face melted together with my foundation as well as the cream contour side. I give this hack a 7.5 out of 10.
Hold up, you want me to do my makeup only using food? I'm gonna do it. First, I'm gonna do the foundation and contour, and we're gonna do it with corn. I tried to cut it like this so it would be easier. Is this really happening? Well, yeah. If someone told me I was gonna be rubbing a corn on my face, I would not believe them. But life does surprise you sometimes. Then I'm gonna contour with the peach. Somehow I feel like this is gonna be good. I mean, pretty mid. When life gives you peaches, you contour. Okay, I'm gonna do blush with this pepper. I really need to be stopped. I do. It's actually really good for nose contour. This is like perfect. Now I guess let's blend everything. If you want to see that, go to part two. And pray for this little mushroom. Welcome to part two of me doing my makeup only using food. Yeah, it's getting pretty weird. Let's blend the contour, I guess. I really don't know how I'm supposed to do this. I mean, it's not that bad, but it's definitely not good. I had to use a different mushroom for the concealer. That is officially the weirdest sentence I have ever said. Okay, I'm gonna use the peach for the powder. It has hairs, so it's gonna work. I don't know if I'm enjoying this or not. Why is this low-key fire? I would recommend this one. And the last thing is grapes. I had an idea, but I'm not sure if this will work. Okay. I think it's cool. And this is the finished look. I would say it's really cute. What do we think?
Hi guys, today I'm gonna be putting on my makeup with a toothbrush. Let's just get right into it, I guess. Putting some of this on the back of my hand. Dab, 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 dab. Okay, here we go. It looks like I got scratched by a hyena. I'm gonna give her a little bit of a thicker layer over here. My sensitive skin really said no. Is it cheating if I use the back? Because the front just ain't it, Chief. This is weird. I feel weird. Okay, let me try something. Can we get some freckles? Oh no. What do we think? What's up, you guys? I'm gonna be putting on my makeup with candy corn. So I have my piece here. Let's start with foundation. I guess I'm just gonna do this and then start rubbing her on. This is gonna take a long time to blend. Now let's do concealer, contour, highlighter, blush. And now we blend. Gotta get the blush. Half of the base done so far. This is taking forever. Some lipstick. Now I'm gonna smoke out my lash line with some dark brown. Mascara. This has absolutely no business looking this good. 9 out of 10 would recommend. Hi guys, today I'm gonna be doing my makeup with clay. Okay, let me put some foundation on. Here we go. So it already is a lot harder than a beauty blender, but it seems like it's blending pretty good. It's also absorbing a lot less of the product than a beauty blender would. All right, so I would say the foundation blended in pretty good. Let's pop on some concealer. Now I'm gonna try and blend that out under my eyes. Now I'm gonna put on some cream contour and some blush. Let's see if this will blend out. Honestly, I think my base looks awesome, so 10 out of 10 would recommend.
Okay, apparently this is where you're supposed to contour your face based on the filter.
Okay, so according to this filter, this is where we should be contouring our cheeks. So I'm gonna be testing it out. I'm gonna be using the Fenty Contour Stick in the shade Mocha. Now I'm gonna just follow that line. Now that's definitely higher than I usually would contour, so I'm doing this half where I normally would. Okay, there's a huge difference. Let's blend them in. I also contoured darker than I usually would, so we can see a dramatic difference. So here is our filter side, and here is our normal side. I feel like the filter side looks more lifted, and the normal side looks more snatched. What side do you guys prefer? Let me know in the comments down below. Hi guys, today I'm gonna be doing my makeup with a paintbrush. Put some foundation on my hand. All right. It's actually going on pretty smooth. Let's get the other side. It's going on a little bit streaky, but that's all right. Let's get the forehead. Let's pop some concealer on and see if we can blend that out. Honestly, I don't think it did that bad. It did absorb a lot of the product though, so I give it an 8 out of 10 and would recommend. Hi guys, so today I'm gonna be doing my eyebrows with tape. Okay, so I'm just brushing them in place and now we're just gonna make like a little map situation. Just gonna put this one here. Gotta get one down the center. I'm not gonna be able to open my eye after this one. And one more to finish her off. Now I'm just gonna take my brow product and fill it in. Love that I can't see what I'm doing. I don't think I want to see what I'm doing anyways. I'm just gonna take some of my brow powder in there as well. Reveal in 3, 2. Okay, it's actually not that bad.